Back again with another unboxing video. This time I'm looking at the Numart Scratch. This is a budget mixer that can deal with Serato and analog vinyl. So without further ado, let's get into it. So this is what we're presented with, the Numart Scratch. It looks like a typical battle mixer with the modern Serato functions on it. We got, you know, your standard two channels, you know, standard crossfader. We've got EQ, high, mid, bass, and we have filters. We have extra gains. We've got a line switch for line, phono, and computer. This works directly with Serato DJ. This particular mixer comes standard with a mini inner fader, so I'm going to test that out and see how good it is for scratching straight out of the box. I know you can upgrade it to an inner fader pro, but I want to see how it stands on its own. The up faders are just standard. I want to see how well they can take a bit of a beating with scratching and stuff. We have a crossfader reverse, and we have a different curve for the crossfader, you know, fade, smooth, or sharp. We have four buttons here, and these will control Serato. You can control different functions like loops, cue points, loop rolls, that type of thing. We have the pad mode button here, which you can switch to all them functions. We've got the shift. That's handy with Serato, so you can, like, you know, customize things and, you know, use extra functions. It also has some effects that work directly with Serato. So we have echo, delay, flanger, reverb, V echo, and phaser. Now, these effects are not built in. You need a computer to operate these effects. And to switch the effects on and off, we use these paddle buttons here. So you can hold it. It'll just, like, click to the top, and you can just use the effect momentarily by toggling using the downstroke on it. We have loop functionality here, so we can adjust the loops and activate them really quick. We also have built-in filters, low pass, high pass. We have a mic input, and we can change the tone, high and low. We've got volume for the mic. And we have two volumes. You know, we have the master mix and the booth monitor mix. Looking at the front panel, it's pretty basic, but it's got everything that we need on it, really. It's got, you know, the big headphone jack and the mini headphone jack. You can control the volume on the front of it. On the flip side, we have a kettle lead, you know, which is standard for all mixers nowadays. We've got the power on and off. We have a USB hub for plugging in into our laptop and using Serato with it. I like that it has unbalanced XLR outputs. We also have extra RCA outputs, and we also have an extra booth output, which is RCA also. It's just basic two channels. So we have channel two, channel one, which are RCA. We've got a grounding adapter there, and we can switch between line and phono for each one of the channels. We also have a microphone input, which is balanced. It can take jack or XLR, which is great. So yeah, I'm going to hook this up to a turntable and check it out. What are my first thoughts on the new Matt Scratch? Well, out the box, it's a decent mixer. You know, it's a low budget mixer, but it feels pretty sturdy. I'm not sure how long the faders will last and the crossfader, but you can upgrade that to an Inner Fader Pro, which I might do at a later date. The paddle effects feel good. They feel solid, you know, really responsive, especially when using it with Serato. All the buttons feel good. They feel a little bit like MPC buttons. You know, they've got that rubber feel to it, and they kind of bounce when you hit them. The filter pots feel good, really responsive. And I like that they're actually bigger than everything else. So, you know, they're easy to use and it's not too cluttered around that area. The EQ is a little bit cluttered, you know, but yeah. You can navigate, you can definitely get by. Maybe I'd say they're a bit closer together, the pots and the dials. But overall, it's a decent mixer, you know, especially for the price. You know, this isn't no like top review or anything like that. I've just recently purchased it. I just thought I'd do an unboxing video and just share it with you guys. So yeah, I'll see how it holds out in the next couple of months, and I'll let you know. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe and check out more content and videos coming soon. Cheers.